I am gonna work on this ocean. Before I move on to the cliffs. It's a little too transparent. To a nice bright sort of halo across the top there. So far, I've only used two brushes for this whole painting. This is almost a monochromatic piece so far, though. Sure, this is coming straight down. Thank you. Hey there, Matt. Thanks for watching again. It's more like a photo. The light source king. Well, thanks, man. I hope it doesn't look like a photograph. I want it to look like a painting. I want it to look real, but at the same time, being a photograph is much different than looking like a painting, so. See a couple little orangey spots here and there. Thicker with the paint now. Some of this, maybe I'll do a little more orange down here. there is where my figure is. Too red there. That's better. That's a little better. Are there crickets? Oh no, there are crickets outside. Yeah, I like hearing the crickets, actually. It's very peaceful sounding. Let's do something fun with this water here. Looks like little waves are coming in. That's real loose. This might help give it a little sense of flatness and depth. There's really not much going on there. It's very loose. But boy, that's effective, isn't it? Just a touch. Kind of why I like doing paintings larger, because then I can be a little looser with the brushwork, and it looks good. Let's darken that up a little bit at the bottom here. There we go. Shannon hates crickets. Well, that's hilarious. Well, if there's one in the house, yeah. Oh. Took you a while to figure out it's coming from your phone. You probably thought you had a cricket in the house. Yeah, in the house, it's a little different. We actually had one in the house several weeks ago, and I actually didn't mind it. I thought it was kind of relaxing sounding. We named him. His name was Chachi. Chachi Cricket. He was there for like 2 weeks. Eventually, we found him. He crawled out of nowhere, probably like half starved to death. And we took him outside, so he lives outside now with all the other crickets. We like to think that he comes back and says hi once in a while. Chachi Cricket. Taking a picture in a while. At least he won't get eaten by a scorpion. This is true. We're not condemning him to that terrible fate. Yeah, that looks good. That looks better. All right, now I can move on to the cliffs here. Okay, still kind of a purpley blue for these. Maybe a little more purple. With a bit of some planes facing the light here. I should break these out a little bit. Oops. That is actually starting to get a little tacky up there already. It's a little sticky. It's been about 2.5 hours. Okay, somebody's spamming our channel now. I'm not in search of followers, primes, and views. We're doing all right, thanks. Go to Big Follow. Let's do a little more paint here. And maybe we'll lose that. There we go, it's probably about all we'll see of that. Cliff there. Here's the underneath of this cliff. little closer. I can add some more depth to those later. Just sort of blocked in for now. Add a little bit of light down here. A little bit of mist. Yes, this is getting pretty sticky already, thanks to my new medium playing around with. Maybe like by tonight, it will be dry enough to glaze over. I guess this is really good if I'm doing like some longer sitting pieces. Some haunches here. I can add more details to this later. Oh, there's the crickets again. You should tell Shannon that if a cricket came in the house today. Nice. I hope she enjoys her new crickets. Play it at dinner and see what she does. You can tell her I told you to. I can picture her face. That look that she gets. And then she'll say, "I will end you." Cool little mountainy mountains. As if they'd be anything else. I don't know what to do with those yet. What kind of details I want. I'm not really sure. They're good placeholders for now. Not really sure how I want to embellish those later. Add some landscaping details all over them. Fog there. Yeah, kind of lose those edges a little bit. Let's look at this. Well, when I sit down, I'm gone completely. I'm standing up for this one because it's such a big painting. Yep, I nailed the look. I know Shannon's look pretty well. I don't know what to do with those yet. Those will definitely require some nice details to make them look further away, too. This dragon is mostly a silhouette with some details on it. Okay. Now I've actually got to design his head, which I haven't done yet. A little bit, but not super a whole lot. Guess I can take a quick picture for the old reference for the painting stages. The lens is all blurry. Let me turn this on real quick to take a better picture. Of course, that makes it get all. See, it sucks because it's better for me to see the painting, but then the video, I can't. It's all shiny, you can't see it. Yeah, my concept sketch that I did is real loose, not very well defined. More just a silhouette to prove the concept. I'm like, oh, I'll just do this when I'm painting it. I'll figure it out. This is a very monochromatic painting. Let's start with Mr. Snout up here. Dark bluish red, all the dark colors. More red, because it's right in front of this light. So we're going to see through that. Now is where I define. What does his face look like? It's maybe a little thicker snout. Maybe a lower jaw there, lower lip. Not completely terrifying and menacing, although that would be fun. Maybe I should. Even though I have to say my dragon series lately has been a little more whimsical and emotional, I do like the idea of having like badass dragons in these situations. Big jaw, big masseter. He's a meat eater, this one. Yeah, there are facial details that I don't know what to do with yet. That's okay, I can design those later. Let's just get the silhouette. Some light diffraction there. Okay, now this gets much darker. He's going to have some kind of spikes coming off of the top and bottom. It's kind of fun getting to design this. I'm like, ooh, what's he going to look like? I don't know. Let's jump in with a dark brush here. Silhouette. Accidentally picked it up on a color down here. Yeah, let's just sort of do the mean general. He's gonna be a red dragon. But the silhouette of a red dragon against the sun might be quite dark purple. This shoulder. He says two shoulders. That's interesting. Thinking about the anatomy for this is weird. And challenging and fun. Okay, and here once again it's going to be there's like the hand. An elbow. So the wings are like this. Which means there would be a little bit of a muscle coming this way. A little bit of a brachioradialis there. Nice big bicep, triceps, and then into the back, which I can still design later. That's a little too meaty. Let's thin that out a little bit. I want them to look like wings, not another set of arms. Yeah, I don't want to look like he's got two arms. Or two sets of arms, even though that's technically what wings are. wings are basically arms with webbing attached to them. Okay, that elbow is a little, it's a little creepy looking, I think. I want it to look graceful. It's bent a little bit. Sometimes you have to do it to figure out what it's gonna look like. Okay, that's not bad. I love how this is looking here, the light off of his nose. I haven't even done it yet, it looks great. Say that, I should just say they. My dragons are they, them. Just because I haven't defined their gender yet. There's gonna be a hand gripping that rock. And maybe that's a thumb right there. Easy to block that in. Knee. It's like a big cat. Big leathery cat with wings. There's the back of those haunches. And there's my foot right there. Yeah, once you understand anatomy in general, it's really easy to play with it. Stretch it. Make it look like it's another animal's anatomy. Here's the tail, which is going to be coming down like this and wrapping around that rock. Maybe around to the other side or something. Yeah, nice big long legs. Like this thing can run or fly. Why not? Do I have a watercolored brush? No, not yet. I do now. See the hint of a patella there. Those little anatomical details are super important. Yeah, this thing can like jump. This thing's just got huge legs. I don't know where those came from, but they're awesome. Maybe they're a little long. Yeah, I think that's a little long. It could be like till there. That's going to be way longer than the four paws, which could be strange.
Yeah, its front legs are a little short compared to the back. It's hard to say because it's standing on a weird angle.
I want it to look like it's crouching a bit. Let's shorten that up a little again. And let's shorten this again. Oh, there's the crickets again. I like painting at night. When the crickets are out, I don't put on any music or anything, I just listen to them. It's kind of nice, actually. Let's make this a little shorter. There's his heel. Is that better? Weird problems you encounter in the middle of your painting. And maybe the legs are a little longer so that you can do some sweet, like, high jumping. Let's look at it through my phone. It's all right. That's all right. Maybe we'll make these lower legs a little longer. I feel better about that. And a little sturdier too, maybe a little bit beefier there. And back here. That's a little better.
Even this that much.
Yeah, that looks better. like fingers gripping that thing. See another foot a little bit. We'll see another foot here too. Some kind of a crown. Cool. Horny structure. Thank you. process. An eye socket right there. Totally just making this up as I go along. You can almost see a top angle on his head, just a little bit. Nice big old horns coming out there. What is that? A coat hanger? What is that icon you posted, Keith? I have no idea what that is. See a little light. Oh, there's motorcycle guy. I'm surprised we've only heard him once today. That's a cricket. I don't. Oh, there we go. It's kind of like a blue background. Okay, that's where he lost half of it. Okay. It's a cricket. This is standing here all day is a lot harder than sitting. Makes me want to take breaks more often. What
Boy, those dogs just bark all day, don't they? He's got some on the bottom too, I can't forget that. Yeah, I get the windows open because this medium I'm using was kind of fumey last night. So I'm like, well, maybe I should have the window open, but now it's like, maybe I'm regretting that decision. Maybe these are smaller on the bottom. Or just more textural. Let's do a little water there. I guess that is the problem with this paint that dries so fast is now I can't revise it because it's dry. Shoulder. Come on, look at that. Train, oh yeah. You'd think we'd live in the middle of a city or something. Now there's these kids with these ATVs right up and down the neighborhood, just like for hours at a time, and they're nice and loud. Man, it's noisy outside. Maybe I should close the windows. We have double pane windows, and they work really well. More well than I realized. Apparently. Okay. You're enjoying being immersed in my world. That's hilarious. Not only my fantasy dragon world, but my fun car horn and cricket and train noises and motorcycle noises out the window. That's a whole new world you get to immerse yourself in. Who'd have thought? A whole new world. For you and me.
Better than listening to kids fighting over the Xbox. I'm well aware of that. That's why I don't have any. I'm very familiar with what that sounds like. Thanks to you, of course. I think living with you for a year is like, well, this was fun for a while, and now I'm done. It's quiet here at night, and in the morning, and in the middle of the day, and I like it. Except for that shit. Someone else's kids. Still making noise, and I gotta listen to it. Maybe all that comes down like that. We also got a lot of drag racing on our street. That's fun. Here's this pan of the wing. I'll have to define all that anatomy later. Soon though, coming up. Like define two different shoulders here. That's going to be interesting. Oh boy, you hear that? Here's one finger. That's what wings are. It's really, these lines in a wing are actually fingers. I see, you see like an amateur artist, like, you know, or a young kid, like drawing a dragon. They usually just draw lines coming down, you know, randomly, like you have to really think about what they are. And it's like a big long finger, the dragon's. He's like this. Like the fingers are like splayed behind him. And there's webbing in between them all, and between the pinky and the arm too. So like, there'd be one, two, three, four. Maybe his fourth finger will be there. That's like his pinky. It's like a hand angled backward. Filled in with some serious mega webbing. These things are super strong. And then the wings are like either spread out between them or like pleated as he sort of, maybe they tuck their arms in and the wings fold up and pleat down. Maybe that's a little lower. There's another one, we'll say there, and we'll say there. Which means I need to fill this in a little bit. Or that could be the wing behind it, we'll see. make this a little straighter. You might have a big thumb hook thing too, that's pretty typical. Big ol' thumb sticking out in the front. Yeah, they're like that. Big ol' thumb pointing forward to like grab shit with, you know, people, horses, cattle, whatever they're eating, I don't know. And then here's this finger that needs to be lighter. This whole wing is lighter. So he's like got both wings up like that. Oop, my headphones are gonna die. Darn it. Too gray, that's not gonna work. Need another brush, like a nice orange brush. Now we can see through this membrane a lot better. here too. Hey Keith, are the kids home right now? D&D club. Oh, nice. That's fun. I'm happy to know that teenagers still play D&D. Didn't know if that was still a thing or not. Tilly, she should send me her character. I'll design it for her. I'll design a character look or whatever. This should probably be a little lighter still up here, since it's the further away wing. And I'll draw some details in it. This is still all just a block in. I can add details later. I'm going to pull this down a couple notches. At least you had somebody that would eat your cooking. I liked your cooking. I guess that's what you're saying, right? yeah, I miss you guys too. That was a fun time living at your guys' place. Definitely challenging with the kids, so I gotta hand it to you for handling that shit full time. That's going to be a little pleat there that I got to do. That'll be interesting. That's my bottle, my water bottle. That's probably what you heard, Keith, is this stupid thing. It equalizes pressure. And it makes that weird clicking noise. Kind of annoying. Oh, there go my headphones, darn it. Is getting quite annoying. All right, time to close the windows because it's getting annoying. Dogs barking all day long. Well, no more crickets. Actually, getting close to traffic time. People come home from work, so there's a lot of cars driving around. There she is. What's up, Jane? I heard that you stayed for D&D Club. That's fun. Well, you should enjoy this painting, then. That's pretty awesome. You should send me your character. I'll design a cool character image. Avatar. You know, whatever. Since I'm starting to do more fantasy artwork, I could do one for you if you're a person. What is your character? Half orc paladin, or wizard princess. Elf knight. Elf wizard. Well, you know, you mean, there's only so many combinations of those. I was eventually going to be right. Elf wizard. Awesome. I haven't played D&D in a long time. I used to play a lot of role-playing games, other ones than D&D. I think the one I did a lot was Heroes Unlimited, which is like a superhero game where you design your own superhero based on rules, that this sort of derivatives of known characters that we have. That was pretty fun. We played Vampire the Masquerade. That was a fun one. Were you going to be a vampire in this whole vampire world? It's pretty cool. Got the basic features like hair, eyes, skin, but haven't really thought about the clothes. Yeah, that's the one thing I'm not so good at. Sure. Outfitting your character. I mean, I do it all the time with even a painting character. I gotta figure out, well, what the hell are they gonna wear? Usually, I use models for my people in my paintings. So I just have them go through their wardrobe and see what they got. We pick out some cool stuff that looks fun, and then I can embellish it from there once they have a fun outfit on. You know, if they wear some boots that are cool, I can make them look extra cool later. I don't have a lot of weaponry to use as a reference, so I haven't really drawn that many like fantasy characters with weapons or anything, but Yeah, you could go through your own wardrobe or go to, you know, with a friend and pick out some cool clothes and, you know, that's a place to start. And you can just embellish it in your mind from there. You sort of do a faux cosplay and then you can make it up. Make it up from there. I do that all the time. Throw on a t-shirt and pants and call it good. Nah, you gotta go a little more. Take place in medieval times. Yeah, you should go a little more exciting than that. This might be a little more. Yeah, a couple pleats in the wings here. It's kind of fun. Maybe the pleats are a little irregular. Going to the Ren Faire and cosplay of your characters, that'd be fun. This would be a touch of blue, even. This won't be such a clean crease. Yeah, these creases are a little too sharp, maybe. Great, now I have no sky brush color. That's a little better. Character creation. Yeah, that takes a while. That dude takes the afternoon. That's fun, though. Didn't you do a painting of your character a while ago? I think I saw. That sounds like that might have happened at some point. These could be a little frayed at the end. Not perfectly flattening. There we go. Now he's like got him up and they're glowing in the sunset-y light. Running out of transparent oxide red. There's the hand. It's gonna like meet body there. And come back to this transparent sort of wing color here. Little bit of a crease maybe there. Little doodles. I thought I saw that you had done one a while ago. Maybe yes. Maybe I was mistaken. And we will see. Remnants of those spikes as little silhouettes back here, I think. That's kind of fun. Maybe there's one crease up in here just to break up that solid shape. Because they're not fully unfurled, they're kind of folded. let's see, here's this hand that needs to be defined a little better. Big old thumb. Your dad says no one likes his cooking. I think he feels bad. He says when I lived there, at least somebody liked his cooking. Sometimes it's just whack. I remember that he was very good at throwing meals together when there seemed to be nothing in the house to eat. I'm like, where did we get all this food? There's nothing in the cupboard. And he would just make this dinner. I'm like, wow, that was impressive. So you gotta give him that. Somehow food just sort of happens, even when there's none in the house to be had. That was pretty well done. Alright, let's stop for a second, take a break, take a picture. I may have rigged up a black curtain to hang behind me so that I can see what I'm doing, because otherwise I get light reflecting off the painting just from the lights in the ceiling behind me. And let me grab my charger so that I can charge my headphones. Or I should have a cable around here somewhere. Yeah, not charge my headphones. Let's just sit for a second and look at this. It's looking pretty good. Okay. Change this so I can do the dragon while I'm sitting. I can spend some time on him. Yeah, I might do that. Maybe rearrange this so I can sit here and work on this. Sending a picture of the written stuff. Oh, sure, that'd be fun.
And the backstory.
Yeah, I'll take a look at that. Okay, that's better for now. Let's see. Chill here and work on this. Let's adjust some of these things. So many things to adjust, just so I can see it differently. Don't mind me, I'm gonna move the camera, which sometimes is a little tricky. There we go, it's even a little more close. A little closer to see the dragon. Oh, you're texting me. Oh, yeah. Okay. I will look at that later. Definitely need to hang out my black curtain because I can't see behind me, or rather the light behind me is killing the, it's making my reflections all over the thing. Got me a black curtain just to block the light from shining on the painting from behind me. That's much better. Okay, now I can dig in here and figure this out. I'd like to keep this as silhouette-y as possible. Wow, some of this is pretty dry. That does dry quick, wow. So within the same day, I could glaze over this. This is still a test of this medium. That's pretty good. I could gently glaze over that and it would be fine. Nice to know. Yes, I got it. Thank you. Let's do a small little tiny brush. Busting out the size zero. I remember when I was a size zero. There's a ridge. Eyebrow ridge. This stuff doesn't smell that fumey. Now that I have the windows closed, it's not that bad. Of course, it could be terribly fumey and I don't know it and I'm dying right now. Hopefully not. I do always have my air conditioner going all day though. Which is acting like a circulating the air. Totally blocking the whole thing with my big fat head. Sorry, I gotta paint. big, thick brow ridge. Maybe there's some more spikes coming off of the face there. Okay, this is going to be kind of a purple. We're going to get cooler light hitting this red dragon. Hold up some references here that I'm going to use. I guess I'll figure out that face later. Which brush was I just using? This one? Guess I could go a little lighter on that. You guys probably can't even see that. Let me turn the the brightness up on the camera a little bit. That's a little better. I can actually see what I'm doing. Let's do one more. Yeah, that's way too bright in the sky, but you can actually see the dragon now. I'm just trying to carve out some musculature. Duplicity, looks epic. Thank you. We do have prints of this one available. I don't know if Nick is still watching, but you can post that. Here's a little sternocleidomastoid action. Gleam along the length of that neck there. Maybe a trapezius of some kind. Yeah, it's a little too dark there. Let's see a little bit of serratus anterior. This guy just did like a big pile of muscle. Too dark in there. Let's see. I basically found for the musculature, I found some pictures of cats, like large, like tigers and things. 'Cause their muscles are kind of the same is what I'm looking for. Especially the way their legs articulate. Come on. Yeah, their legs is from what I'm looking for here is very similar. Trochanter, this little socket there. There's the iliotibial band, I'm willing to bet. Here's this vastus. patella. And here's this awesome tendon that comes right there. There's another one back here where the calf inserts, I'll bet. So I don't know dragon anatomy, but I can guess based on what I know about people anatomy. It might come out pretty good. There's a squash bit right there as the leg is bending. And then I'll have to see how much of his feet you can see behind his tail. A little bit of a tibialis anterior there. This tendon maybe curves forward just a bit. Bone, pelvis right there. Here's the back of that, probably a biceps femoris. We'll say that's just a little sheen going along by the length of the body. And look at that, it's a muscular dragon. Yeah, this pose wasn't that bad because I knew it was going to be mostly profile. Okay, now this tail. Let's say let's get a little tiny brush for this. Cool, now that tail is curling around the mountain there. Have a little bit of shadow behind the leg. And then we'll have a little bit of a gleam on it as it turns. I'll figure that leg out later. And of course, I'll have to add some scales on this guy eventually. Because he's kind of just smooth right now. Beef out this leg a little bit. Yeah, I think adding some scalies around here will really make it read well. And on this leg, you can actually see a little more color. So this is a red dragon. I want that to read. So I mean, little bits here and there need to show some of that red. Nicely coming through. Bit of a deltoid up there. And a net. I got him. No, I missed him. Let's look. Maybe it's a little darker underneath, the wing here. Now what to do with those eyes. I have to say I don't know yet. I have to think about that, what I want the eyes to look like. I might want it to be barely visible. Let's take a picture. Ooh, man. Alright, that's killing the camera. There we go. Guess I could do these closer cliffs. I might have to leave any minute to go pick up my girlfriend from work. She rode her bike, but she got stuck at work and now it's getting too dark. So I guess I don't want to get involved in anything too crazy. Yeah, I suppose I could crank in those cliffs real quick. Dark purple, bluish, whatever. Maybe this will be a little lighter than everybody else. A little darker than that. Very juicy with this paint here, I think. And I can carve in some other details later. Actually, I like the texture here. I want to maintain that. Yeah, I like that little sliver of light coming through there. I know, because of the medium that I use, this will be bone dry tomorrow, and I can do whatever I want to and it'll look great. I can just glaze over it with some stuff. I'm gonna hit this little more red here. Just at the tip where it's in that light. Might not be that red, but that is pretty cool. Looks like a nice reflected light coming from somewhere. Yeah, it won't be that harsh, but it'll be something like that. This cliff here is just gonna come down. So she's on a ledge. What color is this rock in the light? I haven't figured that out yet. Maybe a little more green up top, actually. I have a green brush. I like that it's kind of this red light coming from somewhere below. Maybe a little too red. make it match the rest of the rocks back here. Little more highlight, not highlight, just lit plane here. Alright, that might be all I can do tonight. Just because I know I might have to drive any minute. Yeah, I'll do some features on the rocks. Maybe that tomorrow. I'll do the figure. That'll be nice. Some more details on the dragon. Scales and some veins in the wings or something. And there's going to be a bird up there. One bird. Big ol' hawk. Yeah, that'll be for tomorrow. Well, cool. Why don't I end this then? So, because I'm going to be leaving here. Well, cool. Thanks, guys, for watching. Be sure to follow us here. On whatever video platform you're watching. So you can watch more of these streaming videos. I do these at least once a week. And I'll be doing this tomorrow to finish this piece. But, you know, to get it to the next level. I might, again, let it dry so that I could do a nice, you know, atmosphere-y things all over it. That'll be fun. Usually it's, like, something this complicated. It's, like, 2 full days of painting, and then let it dry for a while, and then do some atmosphere-y things for, like, an hour. So that'll happen later. And check out our Patreon if you want to subscribe. I don't know if Nick is watching. Can post links to buy this piece. See if I can find. Nope, too far back. There's our Patreon page. Here is all of my work. That's we're doing a 40% off sale right now. So check that out if you want to buy a print of this piece. You can pre-order one. And the original, of course, is still available, the original oil. Yeah, that's it for now. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you tomorrow. I don't know, like 1-ish is usually when I jump on. So don't set your alarm to it because sometimes things come up where things take longer to get ready or if you need to figure out what the hell I'm doing with the painting. But, 1-ish. So awesome, guys. Thanks.